On the evening of October 17, 2015, it was relatively quiet in the scenic tan fjord southwest of Mount St. Elias along the coastline of Alaska. It was 8:19 p.m., meaning that the last trace of any sunlight in the sky was about to disappear. Suddenly, the peacefulness was interrupted by a loud boom and rumbling coming from the northeast. This rumbling was a symptom of a deadly hazard which had just been generated. Not just an ordinary tsunami, but a mega tsunami. This mega tsunami would go on to peak in height at 193 meters or 633 feet and seemingly towered over much of the fjord. As this massive wave flowed from its source, it remained tall but quickly lost its height. At 3.5 miles distant, the wave reached a height of 64 meters, while at twice this distance, the wave peaked at just 15 meters. Large swaths of land were flooded along the way, causing an entire island to be washed away, while its adjacent larger island was greatly reduced in size. What occurred on that day was the tallest tsunami to hit a part of the United States in 35 years and had the potential to be incredibly deadly. Luckily, no one was harmed by this event as the area is completely unpopulated. In fact, it wasn't even initially known that a tsunami had even occurred until very small tsunami waves of only a few inches were picked up at two different towns more than an hour and a half later. Today, you can find telltale signs of how high the tsunami reached by a notable barren patch of land present which extends across much of the fjord. Unlike many other tsunamis which have struck the coast of Alaska, the tsunami generated on that day did not originate from a large magnitude earthquake. Instead, this event was triggered by a large landslide, which when combined with the area's shallow water and U-shaped profile allowed for towering waves to slosh back and forth like in a bathtub. So, why exactly did this landslide occur if not due to an earthquake? The answer relates to the adjacent glacier called the Tyndall Glacier. Since thorough record-keeping and mapping of this glacier began, it has been consistently retreating. Whereas in 1969 the glacier was here, by 1983 it had retreated several miles back. And, since then, the glacier has retreated even further to a significant extent, bypassing an incredibly steep glacially carved wall. This wall is inherently structurally unstable and was previously held up by the glacier. With the glacier gone, there was no longer sufficient mass to hold up the cliff, so it slowly began to slide at a few feet a year in 2002. By 2015, this landslide had cascaded until a breaking point was finally reached. Suddenly, 180 million cubic meters of rock all at once slid into the water below at a speed of several hundred miles per hour. Upon impact, it generated a towering tsunami with wave heights maxing out at 193 meters or 633 feet. Due to the southeastward direction of the initial landslide, the resulting tsunami created the highest run-up heights on the south and eastern shorelines rather than the northern shorelines. About a minute later, the tsunami impacted two islands within the fjord with wave heights of 19 meters or 62 feet. Since both islands formed due to sediments from glacial retreat, they were incredibly prone to erosion. The mass of the wave absolutely obliterated the smaller island and removed the majority of the larger island. Whereas before 2015 the tree line looked like this, after the tsunami it looked like this. Exiting the fjord branch 9 miles away, the tsunami still reached an impressive height of 15 meters. However, after traveling 3 miles further, the tsunami was only 11 meters tall. As a whole, this event was quite similar to the more famous Lituya Bay tsunami in 1958, which reached a maximum height of 524 meters or 1,720 feet. However, that tsunami involved a greater volume of material and steeper trajectory of the landslide. While Lituya Bay has produced 6 large tsunamis since 1750, Tan Fjord has only produced one. However, adjacent sections of the cliff which did collapse are still oversteepened, meaning that similar large tsunamis might be generated in the future. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank Joshua Phil Garlic for increasing their pledge on this channel's Patreon.